What are the side effects of enclomiphene? So in this video, I'm going to deconstruct some of the things you can look out for when it comes to enclomiphene. I'm going to show you how you can avoid some of these side effects. Dosing and timing does matter, but what matters more than anything is working with a team of medical professionals who understand enclomiphene, they understand hormone pathways, they understand peptides, but most importantly, they understand your physiology and the uniqueness of your biology, because every single one of you are different. So this is not medical advice. This is not me telling you, hey, you may have low testosterone, get on enclomiphene. This is meant to be educational. And side effects are a real thing. And my job is to get you healthier every year. And that's one of the reasons I create content like this, is so it gives you a vision for a better future, a vision for you having your health and your vibrancy every single decade of life, where every decade you're getting healthier and healthier. But the thing that I want to do is I want to make sure that there's not anything that would interfere with that. So in using these medical innovations, like peptide therapy, stem cell therapy, microbiota therapy, these things are very critical for your future health, but you got to do them in the right way. Work with the right team. Don't purchase enclomiphene or peptides on research-based sites. That can be very detrimental to your future health. And also, make sure that you don't ignore these things and take action. Do the things that are necessary. So with that said, let's jump into some of the side effects. One of the things that enclomiphene does is it stimulates this pathway called the HPG axis. So that's the hypothalamic, pituitary, gonadal axis. And what that does is when that axis is healthy, you're going to have healthy LH and FSH levels, or luteinizing and follicular stimulating hormone pathways. And that will increase your natural testosterone. That's almost like, you know how you have water in your house, hopefully you do, and you turn on the faucet and water comes out. Well, that's what LH and FSH does, is it turns on the faucet so your body can start making more testosterone. Now, if you have not handled getting a great diet, handled your stress levels, if you're not exercising, always do those things first. Detoxify your body. It's really important so that you can get that water gets turned on and you got this pure, beautiful testosterone. And you want to make sure that you can transport the testosterone, get it into the tissues so that you can benefit from it. I've seen a lot of patients and they're really excited when they see their total testosterone is in the optimal range. It's like 900. I just had a patient yesterday and he's like, I got great testosterone. I'm so excited. And it was our first time meeting. And I said, well, unfortunately, your free testosterone is very small and your sex hormone binding globulin is close to 100. So all of that beautiful testosterone, that water that's coming out because your body's turned on the faucet, but it's not getting transported to where it needs to go. It's all being stuck on the proteins, the sex hormone binding globulin protein. So that's because he had too much toxicity. He looked at, is it liver enzymes? His liver enzymes are elevated. His immune system, he had massive counts of neutrophils and monocytes and eosinophils. So parasites, mycotoxins, and a bacterial infection are what we're going to explore next through a test called the biome burden. We're going to do a gut test. And that's really how you want to start. You want to deconstruct it. In the gut, you have a pathway called beta-glucuronidase, and that's what unconjugates and conjugates hormones. If that pathway is not optimized, you just won't get the same benefits. So enclomiphene side effects, they can be worse if your body is not in an optimal state. One thing that we'll see is you can get this excess sebum production, and that can lead to some acne breakouts, even with enclomiphene, and it's not as exaggerated as some people experience with testosterone. We even see this with DHEA, and that's where we always go back, where the skin is a secondary detoxification system. Largest organ in your body, but if your liver's not working well, if you're not having great bowel movements, then the skin has to take the burden on of detoxification. This other aspect is when you're increasing testosterone, the most active version of testosterone is called DHT. And DHT can aggravate the skin, it can aggravate the scalp, and that can lead to some male pattern baldness. That's where you can get the patch around the back of the head. You can get the cul-de-sacs, which I've got some cul-de-sacs. I'm working on that, so don't worry. But the big thing is if you can use peptides like BPC-157, thymosin beta-4, that can help reduce some of these inflammatory issues. You can add in a peptide called KPV and GHK copper, and these peptides are great for the skin. If you want to protect your skin against sun damage, melanotan 2 is amazing for libido, sexual function. It helps ward off the mycotoxin exposures, but it also creates a little bit of nice tanning. The other thing is promoting cellular repair. So making sure you've got a good recovery session in with using enclomiphene or any kind of hormone enhancer. Enclomiphene, as it does have a tendency to increase DHT, you want to make sure that you've got really good liver health. One thing I recommend is just take a glass of water. And I learned this from Dr. Eric Berg. Shout out to Dr. Berg. Go to his YouTube channel. He's crazy, is all over the world. But you put in a little bit of apple cider vinegar, you put in unsweetened cranberry juice, and then you also put in a little lemon juice, and it acts as an astringent. And that can help open up the filtration systems. I like to use cell core binders, so biotoxin binder, Virad Chem binder. These are all really good for keeping your body cleaned out. The other side effect that we've seen is libido can increase. And most men, they're like, this is great, even women, obviously. What some men have reported is the libido gets too strong, that urge, and so it becomes a distraction. Women generally experience more mood swings on enclomiphene than men do because of its estrogen modulating effects. And so that's where taking it in the follicular window primarily is going to be the best bet against these mood swings that can happen. Timing is the most important thing for women, because in enclomiphene, it's used with the ovulation cycles, and that's critical because if you're using it outside of that window, a lot of people have expressed severe irritability or anxiety. They've noticed delayed ovulation or menstrual irregularity where you're spotting. Also, there's an increased risk of cyst formation in the ovaries. So if you have ovarian cyst issues or polycystic ovarian syndrome, you may want to avoid enclomiphene. But once again, this is where it's most appropriate. Talk to your medical provider, talk to your doctor about this before you'd ever try experimenting with something like enclomiphene or any hormone replacement on your own. But this is where individualized protocols are going to be the best. Some of the things we've found for libido with women is you can use Kisspectin 10 or PT-141. And these can be layered in throughout your cycle for sexual health, increased libido, without those mood-related side effects. And so one of the studies, if you're looking at this, you're like, oh, I want to avoid the side effects, but I do want to increase my total testosterone. This test was done on men, and it was conducted in 2016. It was published in the Journal of Clinical Endocrinology and Metabolism. And the title of the study is Comparative Evaluation of Enclomiphene Citrate and Topical Testosterone Replacement in Hypogonadal Men. Hypogonadal meaning they had a loss of their own testosterone production. And this was conducted in multiple research facilities throughout the United States. It was double-blinded, it was randomized, controlled trials, so this was like the gold standard in research. And as they compared this, they took 120 men, half of these men got the enclomiphene citrate, the other half got the testosterone gel. And what their conclusions were is that the enclomiphene increased in endogenous testosterone, endogenous meaning testosterone produced by your body, and LH and FSH levels increased significantly. Acne and elevated libido were more common in the enclomiphene group compared to the topical testosterone group. Side effects were dose dependent and resolved once the dosing was adjusted or they were off the medication, so it wasn't permanent. So there's some interesting things on the side effects, but once again, the best way to circumvent side effects, get your body optimized, get rid of those epic triggers, clean up the gut, the liver, the filtration systems, and you'll do so much better on this. And actually, you may even just have natural levels of optimized testosterone. So if you love this video, if it intrigued you, please subscribe. I really appreciate the support of the community here. Put a comment in the show notes. I want to hear from you. And then I've got a video on why timing matters so much on Enclomiphene. I'll provide a link for you in the show notes below, and I'll see you on the next video.